the Atlanta Hawks. They obviously had issues with health and safety protocols, bringing in gentlemen at the last second. There were players who did not know where the locker room was, so I can't expect that they knew where their defensive assignments would be. Career night, Cam Reddish had 8 3-pointers. Yeah. It wasn't his career high in total points, but shooting was very good from behind the arc. This Atlanta Hawks team, can they figure this out? I mean, it's hard to say without all their bodies.
You know, it's an interesting year for them, and we were talking about it before we came on air a little bit. I mean, when you look at their record right now, with their 2 or 3 games under 500, coming off the Eastern Conference Final last year, you would have thought that this team would come back, be together, be solid, and really be having the type of run that Chicago is having right now, or even, you know, a Cleveland is having right now. But when you look at Atlanta, you just say, okay, what's going to be the thing that lights the match, or will they find the thing to light the match? Because right now, you know, their record is their record. Even though they have some good performances, you know, their record is their record.
Sean, they gave up 130 points. Defense has been an issue for this team. Is that a problem they can solve at this point?
Well, it was an issue for them last year, and they turned it around. They had a coaching change and went to the playoffs, went to the Eastern Conference Finals. But they have a 6-game road trip coming up. It's the longest road trip of the season. They've got to play the Bulls again. And, you know, John Collins is out. We don't know for how long he's going to be out. DeAndre Hunter is probably not going to come back during this road trip. I think this team has to find out where they are, look deep down into their soul. They've got to come up with an answer defensively, and they can't afford to miss another player. This is an important stretch coming up. They have to reestablish themselves in the East. Right now, the Hawks are flying south.
Yeah, but, you know, what I don't see is that determination to be dominant.
Yeah.
You know, like when you've been to the Eastern Conference Finals, and I know when the first time we got there, then it was like, okay, now I'm thirsty. Mm-hmm. I'm real thirsty. And we all want to get back to get to the next level. I don't see that thirst, that hunger, that determination to let everybody know that my team's better than yours, my team's better than yours, mm-hmm. and don't even try to compete with us, because right now we're only chasing Boston and the rest of you guys really don't matter.
Well, you know, right? That thirst is in Chicago.
Yes, you know? That's where we see it at.
And you know, we just heard it.
That demon, and the Hawks should have that. You're right, Isaiah. Once you get there and you get a taste of what it's like to get into the Eastern Conference Finals, and no one expected them to be there, and you play the Bucks pretty tight. Yeah, I know Giannis had some injury issues, but again, you've established a foundation for this young team, and the young team's supposed to show some growth. We can talk about DeAndre Hunter being out and Bogey Bogdanovich missed sometimes. We get that. But the bottom line, this is a deep team, as you saw tonight with Cam Reddish. So there shouldn't be any excuses when you're missing one or two bodies.